Boys and girls, before we left school, we were finishing up our opinion writing and writing stories or letters with our opinion and trying to change or persuade somebody's thoughts on a topic. We're going to move into our next type of writing, which is called procedural writing. And this type of writing can be found everywhere. Books can teach us how to do something, recipes can teach us how to make something, and instructions can teach us how to build something. Today we're going to take a closer look at procedural writing to see what we notice. The story is called How to Read a Story. It's written by Kate Munzner and it's illustrated by Mark Siegel. Step 1. Find a story. A good one. It can have princesses and castles, if you like that sort of thing, or witches and trolls, as long as they're not too scary. Step 2. Find a reading buddy. A good one. A buddy can be older or younger, or a person your age, or maybe not a person at all. Make sure your reading buddy is nice and snuggly, and make sure you both like the book. If you don't agree, go back to step 1. Sometimes it takes a few tries to find just the right book. Step 3. Find a cozy reading spot. Outside is fun, but not if it's very cold, unless you have thick woolen blankets and hats and scarves and cups of steaming hot cocoa. And not if it's very hot, unless you have trees to shade you from the sun, a hammock to catch cool breezes, and tall glasses of icy lemonade. Inside is good. Couches are cozy, so are chairs big enough for two. Just be careful not to get stuck. Step 4. Look at the book's cover. Can you guess what it's about? Read the title. That might be a clue. Step 5. Open the book. This is the exciting part. Read the story in a loud, clear voice. Not too slow, not too fast. You can point to the words if you like, but you don't have to do that. Once upon a time, Step 6. When the characters talk, whatever is being said, say it in a voice to match who's talking. I will save the kingdom. I am the most powerful in the land. I'm hungry for lunch. Soon the castle will be mine. Beep. Step 7. No matter what you read, hold the book so your buddy can see the pictures. Buddies get impatient when they can't see well. Step 8. If there are words you don't know, try sounding them out or looking at the pictures to see what makes sense. They were afraid the dragon would burn down the castle. If you need a break, you can pause for a minute and talk to your reading buddy to predict what might happen next. Will the castle catch on fire? Will the princess tame the dragon? Will the robot marry the princess? Will the horse make friends with the dragon? Will the dragon eat them all for lunch? Step 9. When you get to the exciting parts, make your voice sound exciting too. Who dares disturb me in my cave? The dragon growled. Oh dear. Oh no. The robot was so scared, all his metal parts rattled. What would they do? But the princess tackled that dragon and held him down. You must promise you'll leave our kingdom in peace. When you and your buddy can't stand it a second longer, turn the page to read how things work out. Step 10. When the book is over, say, the end. And then, if it was a really good story, go back to the beginning and start all over again. All right, boys and girls, think about this story, and I want to take a closer look on one of the pages in the book. If we look at this page, what do you notice that is different from other stories that we've read or that you've read? I want you to write down some things that you noticed while listening to this story and tell me or show me in your work what you noticed about this story that's different from others.